Everybody, and welcome back to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic to the Sith Lords. We are, I guess, in hyperspace here on the Ebon Hawk. You see the great texture work out the window there? Hey, it's a pretty old game, so you gotta give it a break. Yeah, we found out some interesting things last time. So we're a Jedi, obviously. And we had kind of been captured, and then Kreia came to rescue us, basically. But we're a little bit unsure of Kreia's motives, shall we say. Okay. We can check the feeds. She also lost her hand in a battle against a rather strange-looking... She's in the Bald Dormitory, and we seem to have something in the storage compartment as well. And there's T3. Hey, hey buddy. Looked like you suffered a lot of damage over the years. How much damage? T3's in the first game, so I guess just to explain why he isn't leveled up in this one. He's had some problems. That should do it. You're doing alright. Okay, good. Gain plus one constitution. What do you mean I faded out there for a second? You were shut down.
There is little more left to give.
I just say, your hand, is there anything I can do?
This wound is a physical thing and will fade with time. It was necessary. Some things may only be learned from sacrifice.
That's a hell of a sacrifice. If I felt lost your hand, what would happen if you died?
I do not know. I fear that the consequences would have been more extreme.
I felt like my hand was dipped in molten carbonite.
Then the sensation you would feel upon my death might be less than that, though much quicker.
Quicker? Would it have killed me?
Possibly, yes. And I fear it works both ways. I would not wish to test it, nor should you.
Okay. Well, then we work together, try to be careful till we can fix this.
When battle is upon us, I suspect our minds are prepared enough to shield each other from the pain. I think we shall not have a repeat incident of what happened at Paragus.
Good. Now can this bond of
confess its nature eludes me as well, but the bond is strong, and its roots run deep. It seems the Force flows easily between us. When one of us manipulates the Force to heal or strengthen ourselves, the other is aided as well.
You and Greer possess the Force chain special ability. When either of you use the Force power on yourself, the other gains the benefit as well. That's pretty good.
A powerful technique indeed. Though, as we have noticed, it has its drawbacks.
Does seem to. Can you tell me what's happened since the Mandalorian Wars?
Much has happened in the galaxy in your absence, and since the defeat of the Mandalorians at Malachor V. As you know, Revan and Malak went to war against the Mandalorians, and you followed under Revan's banner. As Revan and Malak fought the Mandalorians in battle after battle, they grew to despise weakness, just as the Mandalorians did. In the end, the Mandalorians had taught them through conflict, shaped the Jedi, and turned them into a weapon against the Republic.
Okay. Jedi Order tried to stop them.
Revan and Malak, and all the Jedi that served them, turned against the Republic and the Jedi Order. Jedi fought Jedi. Revan was ambushed by the Jedi and captured. Malak continued to wage war in his master's place, inflicting terrible wounds on the Republic. Wounds that bleed still.
How were Malak and the Sith defeated?
As all Sith do, without a strong enemy, the Sith turned on each other. Revan escaped the Jedi and returned to finish Malak, and that was the end of the Jedi Civil War.
But what happened to Revan?
No one knows, certainly not I. After defeating Malak, Revan left the Republic, and there are none who know where she has gone. It is said that the Sith remnants turned on themselves after Revan defeated Malak, reducing Korriban to ruin as the Republic still bleeds and struggles for life. Where Revan wanders now, I do not.
So Revan saved the Republic.
It would seem that way from a certain point of view, perhaps. The Jedi Civil War left wounds that have yet to heal. We shall see if the Republic has the strength to survive.
Then we must do what we can to have a chance to recover from the war.
A culture's teachings, and most importantly the nature of its people, achieve definition in conflict. They find themselves, or find themselves lacking. Too long did the Republic remain unchallenged. It is a stagnant beast that labors for breath, and has for centuries. The Jedi Order was the heart that sustained its sickness. Now the Jedi are lost. We shall see how long the Republic can survive.
Perhaps it's better the Republic stands on its own.
We shall see. The Jedi Civil War cost the Republic much. The resources of the Sith seemed limitless. The Republic's was not. Fleets of warships, soldiers, and people were lost. Entire planets were decimated. Their inhabitants dead, or refugees. It is a great burden for any civilization to bear.
Yeah.
And this new threat, it is a quiet thing. Unlike the Jedi Civil War, it drives at something deeper than the strength of the Republic. It is aimed at you.
Because I'm the last Jedi.
The Republic was never what was important, ever. It was but a shell that surrounds the Jedi, just as the teachings of the Jedi are a shell surrounding the heart of man. You see, the war, the true war, has never been one waged by droids or warships or soldiers. They are but crude matter, obstacles against which we test ourselves. The true war is waged in the hearts of all living things, against our own natures, light or dark. That is what shapes and binds this galaxy, these creations of man. You are the battleground, and if you fall, the death of the Republic will be such a quiet thing, a whisper, that shall herald the darkness to come.
That is a lot to take in. I need time to reflect on this.
I would see to that fool in the cockpit, and remind him of our destination. I would not want him attempting to veer from Telos.
Atlantis is a bad just, well, maybe it is.
He is a fool and an imbecile. His potential lies downwards, not up. Watch
that. She does not like him.
His thoughts are slippery. I do not trust him, and nor should you. Such a man serves himself first and his allies next.
Okay. So we learn a little bit more there as well. Obviously, the talk of Revan and Malak is from the original Kodor as well. And yeah, it's interesting. It's interesting actually that what she's kind of talking about there with the Jedi is that it kind of ties in with the kind of new Star Wars films, like they're kind of talking about there that you know, Luke is kind of saying that the Jedi actually need to be destroyed, that they are, you know, even the good ones, they're, you know, the cause of so many issues in the galaxy. Just a black thing there. Okay, fine. Right. Okay, let's talk to Atten.
How's our passenger? She's still aging?
For someone without much to say, she sure says a lot.
Yeah, to you, maybe. I don't usually hear much beyond fool and imbecile. She's lucky she's a Jedi. Or someone would have killed her years ago. I mean, how old do you think she is? She may have been good-looking once, but it takes some hard living to make creases like that.
If she is, could you mistake her blaster hit when I wasn't looking?
Hey, I just got out of prison. If we had a decent Navi computer, trust me, we'd be dropping out of hyperspace into the Nar Shaddaa Red Sector right now.
After spacing that old witch, of course.
Ease off the insult. She was wounded helping us escape, remember?
Whoa, all right. Don't get mad at me. Hey, I didn't ask her to stay behind and get her hand cut off, okay? I mean, I appreciate what she did and all, but she could stand to lay off the insults herself, you know?
You get empathy from you is like squeezing water from a stone.
Yeah? Well, how much water you get from a stone depends what planet you're on.
He's not causing Telos.
Like, we have a choice? It's the only place Paragus had logged in their astrogation charts. Well, if you thought Paragus was dead, then Telos is a dying world they're trying to breathe back to life. Should be there before too long. You can check our course on the galaxy map if you want. It's on the wall behind you.
Okay. Alright, I'll do that.
So, what happened?
To what?
Don't give me that. There were plenty of times back on Paragus where a lightsaber would have been helpful.
You're telling me?
So where's yours?
My lightsaber was taken from me by the Council.
Oh yeah? I thought a Jedi was supposed to be married to their lightsaber. Guess I heard wrong. Were you a single hilt or one of those double-bladed Jedi?
What do I want to be? I know you could not change it, but I quite like the double hilt. I'm gonna go double-bladed.
Huh. I hear the twin blades are harder to master, but they can make enemies stampede over each other running for cover. A lot of Jedi in the Mandalorian Wars use double-bladed sabers. A more aggressive blade gives you more slaughter per swing. Hey, you didn't go red, did you?
Both the blade and the crystal were unique.
Yeah? Unique how?
I want purple.
Must have been something. Sure be nice to have it now. Might make those Sith think twice before coming after us.
I think having it would just drive them to dump me harder. You know, it's a good
point.
Alright,
forget I said anything. Like I said before, you can check our course on the galaxy map if you want. It's on the wall behind you.
Okay. Telos, that's where we want to go. Travel. Here we go. 240p cutscene incoming. I shouldn't take the mickey, because back when I was watching this, this was like state of the art. Let's just hope nobody notices the Ebon Hawk landing here. That could be a bit awkward.
Remain where you are. Lieutenant Dahlgren will arrive shortly to meet you. That is all.
Okay.
If they think we caused the explosion...
Uh-oh. Here comes the welcoming party. They may not know what happened, so don't blow it.
I'm Lieutenant Grin, Telos Security Force. I'm under orders to take you into custody in regards to the destruction of the Paragus mining facility.
Are we under arrest?
You haven't been formally charged, but you will be placed under house arrest pending the results of our investigation. Due to the nature of the investigation, I have no specific timetable to offer you. In the meantime, your ship and any droids will have to be given over for safekeeping. Yes, that includes you. You are a droid, so you will be detained. In addition, we will have to take your personal arms and armor until the completion of our inquiry.
Will I be able to get my gear back?
If you are cleared of any involvement, your personal effects will be returned to you. You will be held briefly in the TSF station until living quarters can be arranged, at which point you will be placed under house arrest. Do you understand?
Sure. I'll cooperate.
Good. My men will relieve you of any arms and armor. Please follow me.
Tell me I'm not going to jail again.
You're going to jail again. I guess some people did notice. Oh, who's this? Who the hell do you think you are? What you doing on my ship?
You will be held here briefly. Living quarters are being arranged for you and your companions as we speak. Someone will return shortly to escort you to an apartment in residential module 082.
A false cage. This is ridiculous.
As I said, this is only temporary while other arrangements are made. I'm sorry, but you'll just have to bear with us until then.
I understand. Does seem a bit harsh.
We might be here for a while. Might as well get comfortable.
Yeah. Might as well. Quiet, just meditating.
Someone is coming. So this is the last of the Jedi. I must admit, I'm a little disappointed.
You're wrong, I'm no Jedi.
Jedi or no, you're the one I am pledged to kill. There is no mistaking that. The Exchange has a bounty on Jedi, you know. You're worth quite a bit of money.
The Exchange, huh? I'm pretty sure some two-bit pistol jockey like yourself isn't one of them.
Hey? I'm more than skilled enough to work for the Exchange.
You bounty hunters couldn't even win a fair fight. You're the cheapest, most worthless mercenary scum in the galaxy. I'd hire a Mandalorian over your filth in a second.
No Mandalorian could match my skills. No Mandalorian could have been clever enough to infiltrate this station, taken the identity of one of the guards, then...
Then what? Overloaded our force cage fields and made it look like an accident? You probably don't even have the guts to fight me. Pathetic.
Don't think overloading your cages had not occurred to me. You're wanted alive, but I doubt anyone will care as long as I bring them your corpse.
Let's get this over with.
Jedi, it is time to die.
Hey, leave him alone. You want to fight? Then try me if you've got the guts.
You have goaded me once, and you shall not do so twice. But I shall dispose of all of you eventually. And an old woman, a fool, and a broken Jedi are no match to my skills.
Okay. Oh, crap. Oh, look at us. As we go, okay, come on, stun. Stun him. Oh, we got him.
The security cameras are... What? What's going on here?
Man down! Quick! Call a medic!
All right, Jedi. I want you to back up slowly. Hands in front of you. Into the force cage. Cooperate, and we won't have to gun you down.
Come on, Lieutenant. They've already killed... who is that? Is that Batu Rem?
No, he was an assassin. He said he was an assassin.
Rem's no assassin.
Batu Rem is on leave. He shouldn't even be on the station. This man isn't him.
I'm so glad someone knows that early after he tried to kill me.
We've arranged for an apartment in residential module 082. You'll stay there under house arrest until our investigation of the Paragus matter is complete. You'll be under TSF protection. I'll personally clear any visitors to your quarters, and we'll investigate this incident to the best of our ability. Officer, get Lieutenant Yima a report of this incident. She'll look into this. The rest of you come with me.
Lisa goes with Lisa Clark's
department in 082 immediately.
And look, I think I was blocking his blaster fire with my hands.
For the duration
which is quite
of
cool. Arrest.
Two officers will be stationed outside at all times. Again, I'll clear any visitors. There won't be another incident.
But just to be on the safe side, why don't you leave us a blaster or two?
I don't want to be in here.
I can't say. We have a ship examining what's left of the Paragus facility now, so your stay might be brief. We'll keep you informed.
Thanks. This is a step up from a force cage, at least.
If there are any problems, we'll use the wall terminal to contact you. Let's go.
This isn't good. We've got to get off this station.
Agreed. Why do we need to leave?
What do you think the TSF is going to find at Paragus? That could bring the SIP... You know what? Forget it. As long as we're trapped here, it doesn't matter.
What do you think, Grant?
We cannot stay in any one place too long. But our path has brought us here for a reason. I must meditate on this.
You always meditate.
We should rest.
Yeah, you go ahead and meditate. As for me, I could use some sleep.
Rest. We're all meditating now. Is anyone gonna get that? I guess I will then. Except call.
Excuse me, you have a caller. Moza, representing the Athorian planet restoration interests on Telos. Lieutenant Grenz cleared him if you'd like to speak with him.
Okay, send him in.
Very well. I'll let him in now.
Jesus Christ. Look at this Joker. Thank you for seeing me. I am Moza, and I've come to see you on behalf of Jodo. How about our leader here? What's this about? You are familiar with the restoration project on Delos? No. The surface of Delos was destroyed during the Jedi Civil War a few years ago. This Citadel station is part of the... since our station uses energy fields sealed off portion of the band surface that generates controls weather, once the weather in a zone is stabilized, new animal and plant life is introduced to reduce the storm leaks. Corporation known as Circa. Perhaps you've heard of their recent troubles. No. Ithorians are well known as ecologists and agriculture engineers. The Zosian government asked those of my herd to expense move the public funds generally. Hopefully TDOS would be a model for the restoration of planets damaged by war. The funding enabled us to purchase flora and fauna from Onderon, upgrade cities on station shield network, allowed us to purify and reseed small portions off the surface. Then the troubles began. Republic relations with Onderon began to deteriorate, increasing the purchase and transport costs of our biologicals and the other. And as the station grew, the Delosian security force no longer large enough to police the entire station. Circa opposed Republic offered to supply and security contracts. Okay, so basically a private security firm has kind of like, I guess, in a way, you know, taken over the station. So how can I help? Jodo Herbert is a powerful priest, a spiritual leader. He sent something upon your arrival, a disturbance, an echo in the force. Jodo felt you might be able to aid us. He bid me to tell you that if you could help heal Telos, it may be possible for him to heal you. You know me? I'm unclear to what Jodo means by this. He says that the echo you felt upon your arrival suggests that you yourself are damaged. He can feel the pain through the force.
Perhaps Jodo Herbert should turn his eyes to his own people, if they truly suffer so.
Wow, rude. Give me, I'm unclear as to Jodo's message, I may have related it incorrectly. If this offer of mutual aid interests you, please go to the Thorian compound here, in residence 082. Okay. Ah, oh, this pleases me, perhaps we will speak later then. Farewell. Okay. Interesting. Our friend there.
Now perhaps we will be able to rest uninterrupted.
I wouldn't bet on it.
for accepting my call. As my assistant no doubt informed you, I am Jana Luso.
Why are you calling?
I understand that you were approached by an Athorian earlier. Doubtless he tried to obtain your help, attempting to purchase it with imposed guilt and veiled threats.
I don't recall him threatening me.
Oh, and I suppose he didn't mention the exchange, helping you with any problems here? In other words, the Athorians won't lead the exchange to you if you work with them.
Okay, he didn't mention anything like that.
Well, no matter. My apologies. I never intended to waste your time discussing Athorians.
Good. Go on.
I believe you're a person of influence. Someone I'd like on my side, rather than aiding the Athorians, whose quasi-mysticism and bumbling foolishness is standing in the way of progress and profit. I'm not asking for your help, though. I'm offering you a job. Work for Zerka and be handsomely rewarded. You'd be helping yourself. If you're interested, please visit our offices here in Residential 082. B44 will know what to do when you arrive.
I won't say I'm not interested because then we might put you on a target. I'll just say I'll come by when I can.
Excellent. Good luck with that messy investigation, and I hope to see you shortly.
We should get back to bed. Whenever they decide to release us, we should get going immediately.
Explain something to me.
I do not have the years required, nor the desire.
Jesus Christ.
If he served in the war, well, Jedi are supposed to be tough, capable.
Yes, and what are they without the Force? Take the greatest Jedi Knight, strip away the Force, and what remains? They rely on it, depend on it more than they know. Watch as one tries to hold a blaster, as they try to hold a lightsaber, and you will see nothing more than a woman. Or a man, a child.
But to lose so much, I guess I didn't realize how much they relied on it.
Do not be surprised. In many ways, even you are more capable than a Jedi. You could survive where they could not simply because you do not hear the Force as they do. It is irony of a sort, and it is why I tolerate your presence now.
But such a loss of ability for a Jedi, it seems so extreme.
He has been gone from war some time. It is conflict that strengthens us, and isolation that weakens us, erodes us. Add to that that he turned away from war, did all that he could to forget it, and the last piece clicks into place. But we have spoken enough of this, and we do him a disservice by not speaking of this while he is present.
Yeah, well.
I've come to inform you that the Talosian government has completed its inspection of what's left of the Paragus facility. It appears that the Harbinger had indeed been present, though it was gone when our ships arrived and was responsible for the station's destruction. Logs recovered from the facility's wreckage indicated that the miners perished as a result of sabotage, which began while you and your companions were either incapacitated or incarcerated. As such, you are to be released from house arrest. However, the Republic is sending its own ship. They have insisted that you remain on station for the duration of their search.
Why is the Republic sending a ship?
To further investigate the station's destruction and search for their missing ship, the Harbinger.
How long would I have to stay?
The Sojourn is already en route, likely not more than a few standard days. Feel free to use these quarters during your stay.
Is the Ebon Hawk still impounded?
The vessel's IND is complete. Please visit the TSF station in Entertainment Module 081 to complete the necessary paperwork at the front desk. The Ebon Hawk should be transferred from the impound docks by the time you're free to leave.
What about my T3 droid?
After filling out the paperwork, it'll be transferred with your ship along with your confiscated weapons and armor.
Okay.
Well, now what? We can't just stick around. We need to find a way off this station. Whether it's the Ebon Hawk or some other ship. We could hit Nar Shaddaa, maybe. If you've got people coming after you, it's where you go to get lost in the crowd.
You know that from experience.
Hey, everyone needs to get lost once in a while. Get away from something, you know? It's no big deal.
What do you think, Raya?
It is difficult to say. I feel we came to Telos for a reason, but we may have spent too much time here already. Even if the Harbinger was destroyed at Paragus, more Sith could already be on their way. Still, there is a chance we might learn of other Jedi here, on the planet's surface. Jedi who might help us restore your abilities or sever the link between us.
Well, what do you think?
Stay or explore Tidos. We need a ship. Let's find the Ebon Hawk.
Makes sense. I'll follow your lead.
Okay. Also be cool if we could get some sort of like weapons at some point as well. And here we are on Tidos. I guess we can go in those apartments, but we probably don't want to. Might be classed as like Etlosians. Okay. Wait, and how do we get out of here? Oh, through here. Okay. Well, at least I guess it's the general public's around, so we might not get like this place. Oh, nothing. Might not get attacked too quickly. Information terminal. Main menu. Download area map. Okay, look out. So we've got the map. Let's have a look at that. Okay, cool. So what's that? Shut bay elevator. My exchange corporation residential module 082 west. I'm intrigued by what the other guys said, but also we need to get back to our ship to get some big money. Exchange corp, they sound dodgy. Yes, maybe we need to go to the like shuttle bay. Get our weapons stuff back. It's much good us just going around punching people, is it? Did we? Okay, now I'm lost.
I hear you.
Just auto level up. I never worry too much about companions because generally, okay, that's locked. Because generally, like, you will, what's around here? Merchant. Do you sell lightsabers, sir? Greetings, my name is Dendis. If you wish to purchase or sell goods, you've come to the right place. Just let me shop. Okay. Moving parts of Pazak cards. No, I won't be playing Pazak. I guess I'll take up mid pack. Just be polite. Oh, he's got a workbench here. What's he got? Okay, what have you got then? Oh, you've got some interesting stuff. You've got a force pike. A long staff topped with a vibroblade. Wow, it costs 3,000 credits. Disruptor carbine, ion carbine, armor. Oh, look at this, he's got some interesting armor. A Charny light armor, it's 3,000. And crystals for lightsabers, which hopefully means we're not too far away from getting one. I actually genuinely cannot remember, like, when you do. I don't know if you do get one on Tidos or not.
That didn't look like an accident to me or my associate here. It looked like you wanted to make a fool of him. Not even an apology. That won't do at all.
What's going on here?
This Sulliston here had a few things to say about us that we didn't take to so well. We're just trying to work out our differences.
I'd like to hear his story.
Ah, the bits are uncut. Go on the ring pangs in my sanchara. Go la maracta dun. Do sit me in falar sen killer follow on don. De rantasa, beni hulen bensilente. Do sene gravalantro, que wapa teratana chingradana. Teriwana jun conata de la laguna tuna. Dai rinto runca recare papanala ranchinga. De racha womenoto torere senesenten.
This doesn't have anything to do with you, stranger. Just move right along. Have a drink in the cantina.
I think should leave now.
Yeah? Or what? You're gonna teach me a lesson? Go ahead. I hate your kind anyways. Keep your nose in your own business.
I don't wanna fight
you. You shouldn't have gotten involved.
Uh-oh. Well, it just so happens that I'm pretty decent. Yeah, I am deflecting the stuff with. I'm using my hand, deflecting the okay, you're down. Look at Crayo doing like kicks. Okay. Why are they allowed to do this?
Dere inte runt och walkar och kvar upp där ibo. En så telepatchen går så där annan är grå grå där nu nåt chollar en. Så där annan gundo så reminner att lorak du kuro katpada. Kära tor man då ringa till kamrada till fibo nu bude bitarna chen idara.
You should leave in case their friends come looking for you.
Dosen torin teri. Gäller det sånt och sen ig rexi konfunso des junkaratata.
Well, I'm not gonna say no, so thank you.
Gosa na grana nanki.
I don't say no to free credits. Did that, can I take their guns? No, apparently not. Wasn't this guy in the cantina? Oh my god, we're gonna get some sweet music. Race master, no, I'm not racing.
Member hey there, care for a game of Pazak?
No. Perhaps later.
Ah, so you must be the Jedi everyone's been whispering about. No more trouble with the TSF, I hope?
No Jedi.
I guess you haven't heard the popular rumors then? Jedi or not, you're the talk of the station. Everyone from the TSF to Zerka Corporation is curious about you.
And who are you?
You haven't been on Citadel Station long, have you? Let me introduce myself. I'm Benok, the man in charge of Lopak Slusk's protection. You do know who Lopak Slusk is, don't you?
No
the two
idea.
Gentlemen with me are Matu and Nahata, Slusk's finest men, other than me, of course.
Oh, leave the man alone, Benok. I bet he'd come out on top if you fought.
Now, Luxa, I meant no disrespect. You're probably Slusk's strongest woman.
It's your skin, Benok. Just warning you. Slusk could easily replace you.
No, I don't want any trouble.
I doubt you could cause any. Trading jabs with Luxa is hardly the entertainment I was looking for. Let's go.
That guy seems like a douche. Oh, look at the band.
Tavadumpa Munsuru Kupla Liyawa.
The best of my dancers, the best I've seen in many years. Who are you? Don Het Nedraboro, businessman here at the Citadel. I did odds and ends, stuffed the circa, and Doma brothers have no interest in. Odds and ends. Do you know what I'm in this business? My stock changes day to day. God, look at your inventory. Okay. I'll be going. So, I think he's the boss of those two guys we just saw. There's this dude over here. He's a patron.
I don't understand your problem with the Republic. It's not like Onderon hasn't benefited from joining.
It was one of the darkest days in our history. Talia sold Onderon to the Republic, and what did we receive in return? Nothing. In exchange for the blood of our soldiers, the prosperity of Iziz has been stripped to decorate dead planets like this.
Look, if it weren't for the Republic, you'd all be speaking Mandalorian by now.
And because we accepted the Republic's aid, we should be indented to them forever?
You make it sound like the Republic turned Onderon into a prison colony.
Perhaps. Only that the Republic did not even conquer us. Our own betrayed us and allowed the Republic to take what it would.
Okay. Well, he seems very unhappy. Gamoran bodyguard, let's talk to Luxa.
Hello there. Fresh blood at the cantina. Enjoy. Your drinks are on me. We should talk. Later.
Who are you?
If you're asking me that, handsome, you're better off not knowing. Tell you what. You just enjoy yourself, and if in the future we have business together, You can come back and we'll have a little chat.
Sure, I'll be going now. Sure thing. Okay. Where the hell are we now? Map. Cantina. Oh, I see. So we're around there, basically. That way takes us back round to the other side of the cantina. I'll just walk that way to unlock the map, I guess. But yeah, I remember when these types of graphics were state of the art, you know. I'm quite sure this would be too acceptable nowadays, but you know, this, to be fair, I think actually this game is always more about the story and the systems than it ever was really about graphics. So around here now, what's this place? TSF protocol droid. I don't think I want to go here. Nothing there. Okay, we're trying to get to the ship. That's where I want to go to first. Have we got like, okay. We don't need to. Arrested. Said Lieutenant Grin said to come here to get the Ebonor. The rest of my possessions have inbound.
I will call up the appropriate information now. One moment. Searching. One moment. I regret to inform you that the Ebonor is gone. The TSF believes it was stolen and is currently investigating.
You what? What do you mean gone?
It seems the Ebonor was transferred to Telos' service instead of an impound dock. However, both the requester and the point of delivery are unknown. In addition, the vessel is not showing up at any government-sanctioned landing site. I would conjecture that it has been stolen, and the TSF records have been illegally accessed and modified.
I knew it! That stupid T3 unit stole our ship. It's probably joyriding through the system right now, laughing at us, laughing at me.
That is unlikely. While your utility droid is not accounted for, numerous satellites track all incoming and outgoing vessels. There is no record of the Ebonhawk leaving the system.
Wait. You're saying the ship's actually somewhere on Telos' surface? I don't understand. Telos' atmosphere is highly corrosive outside the shielded restoration zones. Where else could someone land safely?
I'm sorry. I'm afraid that's all the information I have for you. Of course, the quarters and residential module of OE2 will remain yours until the situation is resolved.
Can I get my possessions back?
Fortunately, your possessions were kept in the
armory. Thank God.
And were uncompromised. I will open the door for you, so that you may retrieve them.
Thank you.
You will find them in the security lockers.
Awesome. Was there anything in the system about our ship?
There was a query regarding the Ebonhawk's ID signature sent from the Paradis mining facility. However, all data collected in response to the query has been deleted. It is likely that this information was removed when the vessel's transfer request was modified.
What am I supposed to do now?
I am not qualified to answer that question. However, it is unlikely that someone could steal a starship from under TSF observation without considerable backing. If your vessel has been stolen, there is a fair chance that the exchange possesses relevant information. I do not know what else to suggest, beyond waiting in your quarters for further word.
I'll be going. Brilliant. Someone stole the ship. Stuff, you know. Holy moly. We had so much stuff. I'll just take those as well, considering they probably owe me. Okay, so, first I guess get some weapons and armor going. guessed that. Do we have awareness? Gloves. Reflex package. Energy shield. Energy shield. Stealth's not really that important for us, but I'll take it. And then we had... we just go for one, I think. And... Kreia, you had... well, you actually had two mining lasers, didn't you? But... hopefully we can get something better than a mining laser. Okay, she can only hold one now. Oh, because she's only got one hand. I should have thought about that. Oh god, okay, well, in which case we might should we give her a let's give her a vibrant blade, I guess. Some better clothing than this. Let's speak to this guy. You have no business with this exchange. Get out of here. Okay. Okay. I don't want to threaten him. I don't want to threaten the exchange. Let's go to the west residential area. Okay. What have we got here? Nothing. Because we have not downloaded the map. We also did a little moonwalk there. Download area map. Good. Cool. Okay. So what's this? Medical facility. Lab station. Ethereum compound. Okay, that's what we want. Is that here? Welcome. How may I help you? Moses sent me to speak with Jobo. How about... ah, you are the Jedi Moses spoke of. I'll be pleased to see you. Thank you, Greta. These are nice parts. Ethorians, that's who they are. Where's this Chobo guy? It's weird running around the station, there actually being alive people here. Moses. I guess this is Jobo Haddad. Glad to meet you that you came. I'm Jodo Habat, leader of the Ethorians here. I'm sorry to impose our troubles upon you, but I did not know where to turn until I sensed your arrival. You sensed my arrival? Yes, I am a priest of my people, an adept in the Force. I sensed an echo within the Force upon your arrival. It is a subtle disturbance unless one is actively listening for it. I suspect you were one of the remaining Jedi. I hope that you could help us. That's why I sent Moser to seek you out. Moses said you could heal me. What did he mean? The echo I felt upon your arrival. however, was not a natural thing. It spoke of great pain. Oh, whoops. He felt the force of it through you, but it was torn away brutally and quickly. The echo comes from the hollows where it once flowed through you. I felt the force, yes. I once felt the force, yes, and it's slowly returning. It is most unusual wound you carry. If you would permit me to examine you, perhaps I can restore some of what was lost.
Your speech is filled with maybes and perhaps. You are bold to make promises of healing while the world under your care burns and dies. You may be able to help, but there is always a price, is there not?
You mean trouble with Circa, right? Oh, the Seca, whatever it is. Okay, the public vision before I draw intelligence. It vanished. Was it stolen? TSF, yeah, we know about TSF and their investigations. However, they don't believe it's no theft. Okay. Sure. I'll help you out. Okay. I'll return with droid intelligence. Well, that doesn't seem too bad, does it, really? Thanks, Jobbo. Anything through here? No. What's over here? Ethorian computer. Okay. Wildlife statistics. That doesn't seem very interesting. Okay, we need this. Okay. Let's go to the medical facility, perhaps, after this. See what's going on there. I always feel a bit weird running around with my weapon out. Give me Jodo, but the human. I can feel his suffering. I did not feel it until he stood before us, but then it filled my senses. Have you ever felt such an intensity before? Only once before, the day I came to Tearless and strode upon its ashen surface. It is a planet's worth of pain. I do not know how he endures it. It is because he has no choice. Perhaps it'll help me to heal panic. It will help him become whole again. Interesting. Okay, this is the medical facility.
Hello there, and greetings from Isis and Onderon.
Thank you. Who are you?
I'm a diplomat from Queen Talia on Onderon. My stay was supposed to have been shorter, but the contract disputes over the restoration project have prolonged it.
Why are you here?
The Ethorians negotiated the export of flora and fauna from Onderon, but with their disagreements with Zerka, the status of our arrangement is in the air.
Okay. Fine. He didn't ask us for anything. Seems empty. I don't want to bust that open for medical supplies. Bust open, did we? Probably should have saved the med pack for that, perhaps. I got a lab station though. Grenades might be useful, but I don't think we can make any, can we? Nah. We don't have any demolition skills, okay. Don't want any of those. Med packs, we have 26. Way Vivarium. We didn't go in there. Let's check out the Vivarium quickly. Because you never know. Hello, Greta. Vivarium should be around here. Right here. Oh, this is nice. Specimens the authorities are monitoring for the restoration project. Leave it alone. Okay, so maybe we'll have to do something with it later. Okay. Well, don't need to do anything with that yet, but it's good to know. Usually when it comes up with something which says, like, you know, leave it alone, it usually means that there is another option somewhere along the line for a quest. Spend like the next 20 minutes just running around. Is this person not Stelosian? Information terminal. Download area map. Good. Okay. Oh, that's gotta be it, right? No, that's not it. That's where we came from. Dobro Brothers. Cantina. Aha. It's down here to the left. Let's go. We've done it. Dock 126. Anybody suspicious here? Traveller, okay. They're just travellers. Who are you? You're absolutely nobody. You're a traveller as well, okay.
Dragonix 1, Gestale, Lurcha,
Jimmy,
Luca Sole Molosoch. Yatuka, Uwanrika, Chotin, Wanil,
Sauraka, Waka. Turn the droid to Zigitil, also, she'll pay you far better. There's nothing to do with money.
We some mogo dosi, Sheba, Dentes, Kun, Mostovi, Gita Yavach, Pictarishan.
Yeah, dude.
Charika Yayakta, in Sobachina, Ninga, Ballo, Chajuxo, Nish, Chortona. Mogachinote, Herembe, Goto, Winanek Puna, Madosa, Chawana Chik, Trumpaba Nakaras Mangra. Cavadumpa, no shuranto socio, no cecuku polino mocata. Cavanata gallo, cavanami donkey grato.
Yeah, you better donkey grato. Okay. Oh, wrong way. this guy. Greetings. Chopper Habat sent me to help deliver the replacement restoration droid. He's entered, they're waiting for you inside. This is gonna be a trap. Oh, we've got any lockers we can open. No. Sucks. Airlock terminal. Open bay tube door. Okay. Here we go.
I'm glad you're here. I'm the only man the TSF could spare, and frankly, I got a bad feeling about this.
Nice, bad one, guys.
Excuse me, Master, but it seems we have some additional visitors.
Uh-oh. I see. Okay.
More where that came from. Everyone down. Let's settle this.
Okay, he's down. Let's get That was most terrible. I wonder who can afford such a thing. I've got a fair idea.
One of the assailants was carrying this.
An assassin tool. Those probably the hard killers could carry weapons such as this. Looks as though this blaster has been heavily modified. Just to be correct. Lieutenant Quinn should be informed as conduct the investigation or leave it with you. You must take the droid back to Chobar. How about? Fear must be most attacked. Yep. I'll take the droid back. Is the droid going to follow us around, basically? Stealth field enhancer. Okay, everybody. Let's go. Do I have to talk to this droid?
Your judgment.
Lead the way. Yes, follow me to the Ithorian compound. We don't actually have to walk there. Okay, good. Thank you, game. I am guided by yourself every time my people send word of what happened at the docks.
I am yours to command, master.
Good. Peace has been read your arrival. You may begin transferring your data into it immediately.
I shall do so now, Master Habak. Farewell, and farewell to you as well.
Great fear, but my PC sent this as a gift for my people. I don't know what you give me, but I found this blast from one of the assailants. Okay, Lieutenant Gren. Thank you. Now what? Gamma Revolution Exchange Circus hired the Universe Syndicate to work against us. Okay, Force Blind Manufactured Arms. Okay. Circuit exchange must be stopped.
Say the word.
He's coming, right, good. We will be back next time. Until then, guys, see you soon.